See next, the figure 1.6 is given in your textbook. What is there? There is the earth axis given 30 degree north latitude. That means I already explained, if it is in north, then we have to mention the 30 degree and whatever degree is there, but you have to mention N or S. That means you come to know it is in north pole or it is in south pole. In this your figure, all this information is given. There is the earth center given, longitude, latitude, new Orleans, north latitude, north pole, south pole, equator thing, equator. Now I think all of you understood what is the equator. A line drawing all the places located to the north of the equator at an angular distance of 30 is 30 north pole parallel. Hence all the places on this parallel will be the same latitude, which is 30 degree N. New Orleans in North America, Cairo in Africa, or Basra and Lhasa in Asia are all located on 30 degree and parallel. The same concept holds good for all other parallels. See, there is a given in figure latitude 30. That means all the parallel latitude on the same, it is of the 30 degree. It is depend, if there is the same equator in the parallel, it is of you got 30 degree also. See, there is a given 0 degree prime meridian. What is the prime meridian? That means this is the equator, but which line is going from the center? See, this is called your prime prime meridian, and it is of the 0 degree. As equator is 0 degree, the prime meridian is also 0 degree. Okay. One can draw one even parallel on the earth at the interval of 1 degree. See, you can draw the parallel line at the 1 degree. Each parallel line is of the 1 degree. First one is your equator, that is at the 0 degree, and your 90 parallel lines in the north pole and 90 parallel lines in the south pole. Such as there is a total 181 parallel lines on our earth globe or on earth surface. See, there is one example is given about the orange. Orange is a spherical. All of you know. There is also some, you can see the some lines are given. And when you come take out one section, then how many gaps is remaining? That means this all the piece, there is a, all section is also of the same space. This is also one of the example for our globe. How it is also show the spherical sphere, it is also shows the lines, right? Okay. In next 1.8. In the figure, angle ABC, DF, DHI have the sum measures 50. However, the distance between A and C, D and F and G and I are different when measures on the earth's surface. That is because the earth is spherical in shape. See, in this figure, what you can, equator, all of you will know. There is an angle given ABC, DEF and GHI. All these angles are same. That is the 50 degree. Whenever it is upside in center or in lower side, the angle you got the same. But the measured on the earth surface, that is the AC, DF, that is the distance if you measure, then it is a different. Why it is? Because earth is spherical. See, there is a figure 1.9 is given. You have to draw, there is a M is given, there is an angle is the A, and you have to draw from the center of the earth to on the equator, and you have to give the point B, and second is given, that is you can give the point C. Now measure this angle, what you can get here, A is on the meridian, it is on the meridian, it is on the equator, so it is the 0. But what about the other, this angle you have to measure. Next is meridian of longitude. You will realize that the lines drawn from ABC make angles at M, center of of the earth, the plane of the equator. Through these points we can draw a semicircle joining both the poles. See, this is our center. When we draw this lines, which I tell you what, there is a M at the center of the earth. These semicircles, you can draw the semicircle, and these semicircles are called the longitude. One of this meridian is considered to be zero. I already told you this is the meridian and it is considered the 0 degree. It is also known as the prime meridian. Okay. The angular distance of other meridians from prime meridian are measured in degrees and are called longitude. This meridian, whatever we are calling hemisphere, it is called the longitude. And this we call, that is the, like this we are called, this is the latitude, and this is called longitude. Okay. The 0 and 180 meridians lie opposite on the globe, forming a circle. This circle divides the earth in the eastern and western hemisphere. See, latitude divides, equator divides north pole, south pole, north hemisphere, south hemisphere, but meridians divide eastern and western hemisphere. Okay, eastern and western hemisphere. That means how important the latitude meridians are important to understand our earth. Meridians in eastern hemisphere are labeled 10 degree east. That is how we are labeled N and S. Same like we have to now label east and west to understand in exactly which direction we are talking about that. Though the earth is used in science, we can tell the exact location of place on earth using latitude and longitude. See, from this, now you can say which are our, these are our latitude. And these are our longitude. Okay. From this we can understood now exactly the position on our earth. The distance between any two adjacent parallels is 101 km on the surface of the earth. The distance between two adjacent meridians is also 101 km on the equator. To locate the places within distance of 111 km exactly, we need to divide unit degree into smaller units. See, degree we know, but we have to mention properly. So we have to use the degree, that is our degree we denoted by this degree. Second is what given, minutes. Minute is mentioned by this, and next is second. Whenever we are going to read, we are going to read in this form: degree, minute, and second. These are the sign given for your reading purpose. Then you can read properly. The circle is of the 360 degree. It is meridians. Zero is the prime meridian. Like the equator is zero, the prime meridian is also zero. There is a total 180 meridian. One east to 179 is meridians. Thus we have 179 meridians in the eastern hemisphere. Next is about the graticular. I already showed your globe, and from this there are many lines are there. The parallels and meridians on the globe form a net that is called the graticular. What is the exact meaning of the graticular? See, these parallel lines and these meridians, all these form the net, and that is called the graticular. This net form is called the graticular. This facility determines the location of place. Thus, we use latitude, longitude for determining the location on the earth. This method is being used even today's modern age quite effectively. Geographical Information System, that is GIS, and Global Positioning System, GPS, and also Google Maps, Wikimedia, and Google of ISRO on the internet also make use of latitude and longitude. See, from this we come to know about the location. Now you understood what is the graticule, that is the horizontal and meridians make the net. It is called the graticule. And this is still, it is used to find out the region or map. Do you know? India region of positioning system. Positioning system. India has achieved self-reliance in global positioning. positioning technology with the help of IRNSS, that is Indian Regional Navigation Satellite System. Locating any place in Indian subcontinent is going to be easy. See, all these facilities were given to find out all our maps properly. So today we are going to today we learn about the graticular, latitude, longitude, meridians, equator. Okay, that which is very helpful to understand our Earth maps.